Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My wife and I are out here caribou hunting, and I thought I'd show you a little bit about canoeing, a few tips that we've learned. Neither one of us are professionals, but we have picked up some experience. Now, for paddling in the stern, notice how I'm paddling on the right side only. One thing that'll brand you as a real novice is to paddle on the right side, and then when you get to turning, paddle on the left side to try to connect it or correct it. When you go too far, then try to paddle on the right side and correct it. And you just fishtail the whole way where you're going. Okay, now the way to do this is to paddle and then sweep out. I think they call that the J stroke. I paddle back, you know, power stroke, twist my thumb towards me and push off from the boat. I use the boat as a fulcrum to gain leverage. Now, my wife and I, when we're both paddling, she'll be paddling in the bow. She'll be paddling just a regular power stroke, just regular straight power stroke, and I'll be steering from the rear. I find that when she's paddling, that'll counteract some of my paddling. So I can get in a couple of strokes before I have to correct. Now, some of the tips for canoeing, some tricks, is, just a minute. This is one professional video, all right? Okay. One of the reasons why you don't want to, well, several reasons why you don't want to swap from side to side, like I showed you earlier, is that when you swap, look at the water coming off of my paddle, getting into the canoe. Okay, so you don't want to do that because that'll get your gear wet, get the bottom of the canoe wet. So that's why you paddle from on one side only. And my wife, she'll pick which side she wants to paddle on in the front. When she gets tired, she'll swap to the other side. When she does that, then I swap to the opposite side from her. Okay, when she's paddling on her right side, she'll be sitting on her right side. She'll be sitting right up next to the gunwale on the right-hand side. And I'll swap over and I'll be sitting right on the left-hand side, right up against the gunwale. And the reason for that is to keep the canoe flat and stable. When paddling by yourself, you always want to put some weight up front. You really don't want to go out in an empty canoe with just a stern paddler, a paddler in the stern. The reason why is because, as you notice, the canoe's shape is well, I really don't know what you'd call that shape, but it's narrow in the front and narrow in the rear. Okay, if you're by yourself in the rear, there's not a whole lot of stability there because you're sitting in the water like this on that tippy narrow point. Okay, so you want some weight in the front to get that front down so that you have the width of the midship or beam to give you stability. Okay, a few useful items that I've picked up over the years. Oh, here's another one. When you're paddling and my wife switches sides up front, she will swing the paddle out in front of her from side to side. I will swing the paddle behind me. The reason for that is, of course, to keep the dripping water out of the canoe. Okay, now, some handy items. First of all, I've got an old jug that I cut the bottom off. That works great as a baler if you need to bail real quick, if you've shipped water over the side. You can get out a lot of water in a hurry. Another handy item that I've learned to use is a sponge. That way, any little bit of water in the bottom of the canoe, say like rain or whatever, you can dry every little bit of it up so that as the canoe rocks from side to side and shifts, your gear laying in the bottom of the canoe isn't getting wet. Now, another item that I've made up is these little clips here. Okay. It's just a circle of good, strong cordage. Nylon is probably one of the best. And with a carabiner type clip on it. And what I do with these, as you saw, was I clip it onto important things. This is my camera equipment in a waterproof box. As you notice, my gun right here, it's got one of those clips on it too. That way, if we tip the canoe over, and once we are able to salvage the canoe and get it out, these things will still be with the canoe. We won't lose these. Okay, notice how my wife is paddling. She's reaching out and pulling in towards the canoe with the paddle before she starts her power stroke. That's to keep the front end. That's how you steer if you're steering from the bow position. She reaches out, sticks the paddle in, pulls it towards the canoe, and then comes back, sweeps back. Notice how she's sitting over on the right-hand side. And now if you could see, I would be sitting over on the left-hand side as well. When getting in and out of the canoe, the proper way to do it is to keep your weight right in the center of the canoe. Put a hand on both gunwales. Keep your weight centered low and in the middle of the canoe. Like that. And when getting in the canoe, do it the same way. Step in the center of the canoe, keep your weight low, and a hand on both gunwales, slide your hands along, and keep in the center of the canoe.